the official opinion of WHO, because I am a member of the International Advisory Committee of this international organization. To date, and after much research performed, no adverse health effect has been causally linked with exposure to wireless technologies. Health-related conclusions are drawn from studies performed across the entire radio spectrum, but so far, only a few studies have been carried out at the frequency to be used by 5G. Tissue heating is the main mechanism of interaction between radio frequency microwave fields and human body. Radio frequency exposure levels from current technologies result in negligible temperature use in the human body. As the frequency increases, there is less penetration into the body tissue, and absorption of the energy becomes more confined to the surface of the body, skin, and eye. Provided that the overall exposure remains below international guidelines, no consequence to public health are anticipated.
The exposure levels in public areas from 5G are expected to be very similar to what we get from 3G and 4G networks today. And that typically puts them around 1,000 times or more below the safety limits. Those safety limits, in turn, are designed to protect all persons for continuous exposure. Earlier this year in February, the ICT industry mapped a pathway to net zero so that the services, the products, et cetera, will be a net zero in terms of the impact on climate in the future. And so we're looking towards science-based targets in line with the recommendations from the UN Convention on Climate Change. And the other thing to take account of is that, yes, there is a footprint of the mobile industry, and we absolutely do need to minimize that and develop the technology in an environmentally responsible way. But there's also an upside. All the flights that have been avoided by joining this call is a huge environmental footprint. And a recent analysis estimated that the environmental savings of the mobile sector were about 10 times the environmental footprint. As one of the speakers said in the first session, if 5G and the other mobile technologies allow more efficient public transport, allow more substitution of video conferencing for travel, allow remote control of robots, allow use of sensors to monitor the environment, maybe there will be even greater environmental benefits in the future.